Howdy, folks. The Punk House YouTube channel. This is episode 3 of Cornell Spears' Zomboid Wanderer. And going into this 6th day or 7th day, I was really worried about the helicopter, and fortunately the night before I went to bed at a good time. We were up at about 7 a.m., and we were able to catch the automated broadcast system, which was really good, because I was like, we're going to have 4 days of me waiting around. This is actually going to be this will be a dead episode where I don't really have a lot planned, and I'm just going to be walking around Ekron doing basic, like, scavenging. And that was not the case. This first day, we had air activity detected, and I just got everything, and I came up to the little bedroom right here. And fucking normally, I swear to God that the helicopter doesn't come until, like, 4 p.m. or 5 p.m., and we hang out in this room all day normally, but I was, like, setting up my little notebook, and I hopped on the bed to read my metalworking guide, and, like, lo and behold, there was the helicopter, 9 a.m., so it was nice to just get that out of the way, and you'll see we end up hanging out until about noon 30, half noon. There's some window crashing over the course of this. You'll see, it, like, I walk over to the door and I just kind of, like, get my book again. I read that a little and I came back over to this corner and I just read. So it's like, man, if there's, like, ghouls in the house, then, you know, there could be one. Maybe 10. They could have just broken the window and followed the helicopter. So we're just going to hang out, listen, and make sure that they don't come to the door. And they don't come to the door. So we're pretty safe. I also was looking at, like, I've in the week since the apocalypse, we've grown a beard. I was like, no, we came in with a mustache. So I decided to stick the mustache in. I try and reformat how I do the notebook, and it just doesn't work. We'll figure that out, maybe, at some point. I doubt it. I just hate how there's no way to nicely split, like, the date and the label and the time. Maybe I have to use more lines. It's another thing to, you know, I'll think about that. But, so with the helicopter having passed, I'm like, cool, let's go get that station wagon that we abandoned past the gas station, I believe, in the last episode, because we want transportation, and now that the helicopter has passed, we have, like, 8, 10, 12 days until the next helicopter, so we can kind of, like, get started on doing stuff, which that just feels nice. So we just kind of clear out the area around our house, make sure we're safe, because the helicopter is going to drag Zeds just left and right. They go everywhere. So yeah, we do a bunch of killing. There's a lot of killing because we end up walking just across town. But it's a time to get some killing, check on some things. I think I ended up going through the tool store. Which doesn't turn up much. I think I get a crap load of screwdrivers later on. goal is just to get the car, fill it with gas, and bring it back to the house. And I want to go to Rosewood, because I want to get axes. I kind of feel like the level of wealth in Rosewood is probably where I might end up finding the sort of RV or trailer that I'm looking for. It's not quite there, at least yet, but I mean, there's other stuff, and we have, again, we don't have it yet, but I do, we go get the station wagon. I guess I came back and I dropped some stuff off. Very exciting. Inventory management. One of the most boring and critical parts of this game, and a lot of games in this style. Especially because, like, right now we're trying to keep everything so limited. So, like, food's kind of an issue. Like, weight is ongoingly going to be an issue, like, right now, especially. I'm, like, real, I'm, like, hurting for a stick of butter or, like, a couple cans of dog food. That would just be, like, glorious, like, right around this time. But I don't have it. So, that's that. So that is also, like, one of the reasons why I'm thinking about Rosewood, even, is because they got the Gigamart, they got the level of wealth, where stuff kind of spawns in, they got the fire station with the axes, I'm looking at my skills, an axe is just, like, a good skill for us, so. Rosewood just has, like, good prospects, I feel like, in general. Like, Ekron, again, although it's central, and we'll end up, we'll probably be back and forth into this town a lot over the course of this run. But as things stand, I'm pretty committed to going to Rosewood. And if Rosewood doesn't end up panning out, like, I end up getting a fairly good stock of supplies that I can bring back out to, like, one of the Ekron houses, and then have to head to another, like, location in order to find stuff, then we'll probably end up going to Riverside. I do think, oh man, me chowing down on the cereal, we ate a bunch of cereal today. We'll say that's pretty exciting. It's funny because I am kind of going, I think our itinerary is going to generally be that we go through the towns in terms of level of difficulty. It's not, like, specifically how things worked out, it's just kind of, like, where I'm kind of leaning, but I might actually end up doing, because that original list would have excluded March Ridge, which is, like, this military suburb town that you don't normally spawn into that has a lot of weapons, and I think I've only been there once, actually. Like, I've been to Louisville more times than I've been to March Ridge. I don't know, I just don't think base building prospects there are, like, great. The cinemas always, like, look cool when I, like, am looking at the map of the game. The cinemas always kind of look like a cool spot, but otherwise it's, like, you know, you get the, or you don't know, if you don't know. The town's just kind of a bunch of these, like, late 90s looking, like, American row houses. Which, I don't, if you have a condo, is probably kind of exciting for you, like, congratulations, but in terms of location prospects, they're, like, kind of boring. I'm saying all this, and I'm like, wow, maybe I am just going to go to March Ridge after Rosewood, so I might have just talked myself into it. So yeah, we go through this tool store. I guess I'm kind of looking for a sledgehammer. Was like the big item, like the item do resistance. Everything else was kind of meh. This wasn't. I mean, it's one of the issues of Ekron is because the zombie populations are, or the zombie density is lower, so the loot options are a little lower. And a lot of the buildings, and this is no fault of the design of the guys who make the game, but the buildings do generally have fewer, like, shelves or storage. Pardon me. Hello. I'm checking it's still recording. It definitely is. I was talking about Rosewood. But so we're back at the gas station now. We're finally getting the station wagon. And if you also notice, it's midnight and we're doing this. So some of you may naysay this, and you're definitely right to. It's generally dangerous to do, like, loot scavenging at night, but I was already, I was, like, in for a penny, in for a pound, at this point, so I was just like, whatever, let's, get the car, and I did, and then we filled it up, and we went back home, and I'm, you know, I'm thinking about the weight thing, so we do get home, and I'm gonna drink a bunch, not a bunch. Well, in a relative sense, it's a lot. I drink like a whole bottle of wine in like 3 quaffs, which is pretty, like, himbo, I guess. But it's like not enough to adjust the steady decline of our weight. That will continue. However, instead, we are blessed with the wonders of energy gain in the time of me not setting an alarm clock. And, I mean, I don't care because, like, the helicopter came through today, so it's like we're not going to have another helicopter again for, it's going to be like 8 or 10 days. So we have some time, at least 8 days. I mean, fuck, it's, I've waited like 14 to 15 days before and it's like not come, so, you know, who's to say? Yeah, so we go to bed and I wake up and it's 12:30 and I'm like, okay, we're going to Rosewood, like, that's the plan. So I kind of drop off a bunch of shit that I don't need, because in terms of right now, like, most of the game is going to just be, I'm just knocking shit over on the coffee table right now. It's going to be kind of finding safe houses, clearing out areas, and looking for our shell. Because I've already said we're looking for the shell. And so, yeah, we drop all the paint that's in the back of the station wagon. And I grab the signature suitcase and I fill that with stuff. And I guess I went out and I just searched the area. I get real paranoid about zombies just being around. It's kind of the nature of the game. Yeah, I'm just like, I'm scouting out how far it is. I get the signature suitcase. I load that up with, like, clothes and weapons, and I get one of the backpacks and I load it up with some, like, weapons and some food or whatever. I shave my face. I got the mustache again. It's great. And then this evening, I mean, I wanted to, like, hit the road, but it ends up being, like, quite late in the evening, when I'm this like two-story house to that previous safe house that we were at, that's just outside of Fallis Lake. So we're gonna end up driving out there, spending the night, and then I mean an average day of gameplay is like I get 45 minutes on average. Oh yeah, I came down to the church right here because I was like, there's a parking lot down here, and I just know how churchgoers are. I was like, there's bound to be an RV or some bullshit out here. But like, damn them, there's some clever preppers. They probably already hit the road. So none of their stuff is there. Now it's 5 o'clock and we're booking it out just to the farmhouse. And again, this time I also forgot the alcohol. So that it's like, there's some at this safe house, but not some at this safe house. So, I know this is a very different gameplay style than I'm used to, because I am looking for the shell, I just can't find it. I'm usually kind of used to finding like some warehouse or some like gaudy mansion or one of like a farm. I like these farmhouses. These like two-story farmhouses are pretty cool. And I end up like living out of one of those. This is how I wanted to play this one. So we're doing it like this. I mean, there's probably bound to be, I was like even thinking about this separately, but there's probably bound to be like better spawns over in outside the Dixie trailer park. There's that like intersection between Muldrow and West Point. There's like probably a good chance that there would be a RV there, but it's like, if I go out there and then hit Rosewood, then it's like I'm just going to two distant parts of the map. I kind of want to hit West Point last, not because I love West Point. West Point's probably one of my favorite towns to play in this game. Don't get me wrong. But I would rather do West Point as the bridge between the county and Louisville. I'll probably just end up hitting points of interest, and then move into, I think it's Doe Valley. So we sleep. And again, that was such a short day, we didn't do anything. So we load up and we head out, and I double check my route on the map because it's kind of easy to get a little turned around in the fields. Actually, I'm on like cruise control 20 or 25 for like a lot of this in the morning. You may recognize that car. But now we're in foreign territories, places on the run where we haven't been. And we halfway south. It's a lovely drive.
Hell yeah.
Entry here was because there ends up being a lot of zombies on the road leading up to Rosewood. And so we end up just pulling a crap load of them. And it kind of nixes the plan to set up a safe house at the gas station. Which I'm fine with, because I'm just playing on my feet. There's this big crowd right there that just, like, spawns in as we, like, pull into the block. It's awesome. There's a bunch, and I'm, like, being a hero. I'm like, well, there's five over there, and there's 17 or whatever in the horde, and it's only 22, and I've got, like, an axe and a bunch of screwdrivers, so we're pretty fine. like, this is totally recoverable. And then a couple more come up behind me, and then a bunch more come up behind me, and I'm like, this is totally fucked. There's absolutely no salvaging this. I have a big group, and there's zero space for me to, like, move about. So I do the thing that you're supposed to do, and I just start yelling, and I pull as many as I fucking can, and we just kind of, like, I'm looking for, like, some woods or something that I can enter into Rosewood through, and there's, like, not any in the immediate vicinity, so we just kind of shuffle across this field. And I look at the gas station right there, and I'm like, fuck, it is two stories. Like, I knew it. But we're in Rosewood, and... like, I see the fence over here. I'm like, there's a fence. We're fine. We have weapons. It's a neighborhood. Like, you know, there's dead guys everywhere. And I end up tripping. I, like, pull these guys. And I'm like, this is salvageable. And it's, like, less than 20 that I end up looking at. But I still end up dipping. Oh, I remember, it's like, cause I was like, oh, I'll have a heroic escape north, and I just trip on them. So our shin's a little fucked, but we're fine. And then, we bring into this house, there's absolutely nothing in this house. There's, like, some peas, and a bread knife. I don't even get the bread knife. I'm like, I don't need this. This gun, but I don't even care. We go to the fire station, and the fire station will be our safe house in Rosewood for a minute. Is, like, get the station wagon on the other side of town, which just means we have to go and, like, kill hordes up and down the main street, which is, like, not an issue. We'll just kind of clear it out a little. There's several nice parking lots. There's a bar, so we'll be able to get alcohol. Like, there's the Gigamart, which will have butter and food. And so that just ends up being the goal for the rest of the day, is, like, let's maybe not, like, get to the station wagon, but we'll get to the Gigamart. Find the fire station, we inspect the fire station. Outside of the, like, three or four in the garage, there's nobody in here. I'm not really looting, because I know space for cosmetics is limited right now. But it's like, cool, we do have a space that's a little safe. And it's got some food, so we eat. We look for axes, and we do end up finding the, like, loadout of axes. And so I just grab one with low durability and one with max durability, and we just start killing. And I fucked up my fence over there, and I do bloody my, or I do get a cut in my hand, which is fine, because I'm only playing with bites zombifying you. But so we are injured. We're injured, like, left and right, actually, which is great. I, like, it's so funny playing against this kind of stuff. So even though, like, we're using axes, we're killing fast, we're getting exhausted fast, and we're just looking, Gigamart is on our sights. I don't care about the police station, we're not looking to shoot guns immediately. We're not sightseeing yet, I don't go into the county, the town hall. More killing. And so yeah, we're just gonna be in Rosewood for a bit. Going into, I mean, we're kinda getting close to the end here. Not super close, but this is kind of, you know, just having seen what's happened over the last 3 days, this is kind of what's going to be driving the next episode. We have to get the car back. We have to get food and be worried about, we just have to be able to put on some weight again so that we're not worried about becoming underweight. I want the car, so we have a car. I want a place to live, so we have a place to live. There ends up being, like, one guy in the bank who does pop out. This was a fun bit, actually, because I go into the Zippy Mart, because the Zippy Mart's great. They got cigarettes and, like, soda. And a bunch of junk food. Like, chips are really storage efficient. We eat a muffin and a burrito. And when we're out of water, I forgot we'd been, like, out of water for a bit, and I just wasn't too worried about it. Because water's still on. And then this, like, little group, like, comes up and starts pounding on the Zippy Mart door. And I was like, wow, I'm just, like, I was having a little zombie roleplay moment. It felt really nice. Or just really thematic. I guess, having a bunch of zombies pull up on you as you're, like, fucking looting the convenience store. And then I get my stuff and go back to the fire station. And that's more or less it. Do a little bit more killing. But yeah, so I love you. Go fuck yourselves. Bye.